This book is called What the Moon is Like by Franklyn M. Branley. The next time you see a big round moon, look for the man in the moon. The dark and light parts make some people think of a mouth, a nose, and two eyes. That is why they say there is a man in the moon. Can you see him? Other people say there is a rabbit in the moon. It has big ears. Some people see Jack and Jill and their pail of water. Maybe a cat sees a mouse in the moon. Next time you see the moon, look for the man, the rabbit, and Jack and Jill. You may be able to see them if you try real hard. Some people try hard, but can't see any of them. If you could see the moon better, it would look like this. The light parts are covered with hills and with holes called craters. Some are many miles across. Others are very small. The holes were made by big rocks that crashed into the moon long ago. The dark parts of the moon are smoother. They are like wide fields. It would take weeks to walk across some of them. They are called the seas of the moon because they are so flat. There is no water in them. There was no water anywhere on the moon. Twelve men have gone to the moon. Look at the map to see where they landed. They walked on the moon. Some of these astronauts rode in a moon car. The astronauts found no air on the moon. Outside their ship, the men wore spacesuits. The air they needed was carried inside the suits. They found small rocks and great big ones. Some were as big as a house. Parts of the moon are flat. In those places, the astronauts could move quite easily. But there are many mountains and hills. Some are smooth and rounded. Some have large, jagged rocks sticking out of them. There are cliffs and deep valleys. The astronauts kept away from them. The astronauts found no water on the moon. The moon is drier than a desert. They found no living things on the moon, no animals, no plants, and no fossils of plants or animals that might have lived there long ago. The moon is a dead world. It has never had living things on it. It is dead, lifeless, and colorless. There is nothing green, blue, red, or yellow on the moon. The whole moon is drab, dull, grayish brown. The moon has a long day and a long night. There are 2 weeks of daylight on the moon. Then there are 2 weeks of darkness. In daytime, the moon gets very hot. The temperature reaches 250 degrees Fahrenheit. That's hotter than boiling water. It is very cold in shadowed places behind big rocks. There is no air to protect the moon from the sun. At night, the moon gets icy cold, about 290 degrees below zero. There is no air to hold the heat. Spacesuits kept astronauts from getting too hot or too cold. Astronauts liked walking on the moon. They did not weigh very much because gravity on the moon is less than it is on Earth. They felt light. You would too. If you weigh 60 pounds on Earth, you would weigh only 10 pounds on the moon. Because gravity on the moon is low, astronauts could take giant steps. They bounded up and down, but their spacesuits were bulky and awkward. The astronauts had to be careful so they would not fall down. When they did fall, it was hard to get up because of the clumsy spacesuits and also because of the moon dust. Much of the moon is covered with fine dust, almost like powder. In many places, the dust is a foot or more deep. When people walk, their shoes make prints in the dust. The moon car had to have wide tires to keep from sinking into it. The dust sticks to shoes and to clothes, too. The moon changes very little. It is almost the same today as it has been for billions of years. That's partly because nothing grows on the moon. Also, there is no water to wear down the hills and no wind to move dust from one place to another. Earth is always changing. All kinds of plants and animals live here, and they keep changing. Earth has wind and water. They wear down rocks and move dust and dirt from one place to another. After the Earth and Moon were formed, big rocks crashed into them. There were also a lot of volcanoes that spouted dust and ash. They spread lava or liquid rock over parts of the Earth and the Moon. On Earth, much of the lava has been worn away. It is still unchanged on the Moon. Rocks in space will crash into the Moon. They make moonquakes and new craters. They also crash into Earth, but not very often. On Earth, our daytime is bright and blue. That's because water droplets, dust particles, and molecules in the air are lighted by the sun. There is no air on the Moon. No dust, water droplets, or molecules in the sky. There is nothing in the sky to be lighted, so it is always black. From the Moon, people can see the stars at night, just as we can from Earth. But they can see the stars in daytime too. In the black sky, they can see stars when the sun is shining. When astronauts started for home, they could see the Moon just below them. Far away, they could see Earth. Someday, astronauts may go to the Moon again. Once more, they will explore it. They will put up buildings on the Moon and live inside them. They may start a Moon colony. Who knows? Someday, you may work in a Moon colony. You may be a Moon explorer. Then you'll see for yourself what the Moon is like. The end.